This is Jinu Joseph, Editor-in-Chief of Modern Plastics TV. Mr. Surendranath, welcome to Modern Plastics TV and Dymold India 2018. We saw so many changes happening on quality and the development in the industry. How do you see the quality improvement and development in the industry in Indian tooling and molding industry?
The Indian tooling industry has of late measured up to the customer's expectation, especially on the delivery front, which has been a failure all through. However, the customer looks at three factors: quality, cost, and the delivery, of which topmost priority is given to the delivery. The other factors like cost and quality is taken for granted. It is assumed to be of the quality we are looking at. However, to improve on delivery, it's not just a issue which can be resolved at the tool maker's end only. It's a partnership which the buyer and the vendor works closely with the die making, which can help in reducing the delivery time. I can cite as year as 1995, the delivery times which were impossible during those times, when we used to talk in the delivery unit used to be in the units of months, delivery time a month, 2 months, 3 months. Today we are talking in days. Some years back we are talking in weeks, which are today the norm is in the weeks. However, in 1995 we have crashed a delivery time of a 14 ton die to US. We have delivered it in 8 weeks. Very close cooperation and support from the the buyer in US was made it possible. So the question is, right ahead, if there is a lot of working closely with the die maker and the vendor when the customer when he wants to buy, lot of crashing, concurrent working can bring down the delivery time, which will be in the interest of the customer. Hence, the need of partnership is very, very important in crushing the delivery time. Regarding quality and you're talking about cost. Cost is a factor which is competition driven. There is a basic a level for which the quality, etc., we just cannot reduce it further. It is a question of survival. And that is usually the issue in our country. The tool makers are cut down to such low levels of this thing, operational costs which they procure, that the industry growth today is not healthy as it could have been. The returns on investment is not at all very encouraging. I recollect an incident as a top multinational company top man talking, why should we put a tool room when I can buy the tool at this thing? But the question is, the tool makers are normally the small players and technocrats which are driven passionately in their tool making, not looking at the commercial aspect of it. And in the course of giving quotes are normally damaging and at the cost of not necessarily making a decent profit. So the question coming is, healthy growth of the tooling industry will be possible when customers must understand that there are basic input cost and all which has to be compensated, and just not talk about competition, somebody else is giving. But let us be very clear, because somebody else giving at a price is not the same as what you are intending to do, your level of making as understood by the customer. The same tool giving you the same product can be made at 1/4 the cost to 4 times the cost, or maybe 10 times the cost. So the question is a choice to be made by the customer and the way the marketing done by the toolmaker himself. Toolmaker needs to stress and bring upon, impress upon the customer in this pricing, what is he intending to give to you. and the customers appreciate if it is in his interest. That I will give you cite examples in which a quality tool has brought down the price of the component ultimately for which he has made it, which is possible provided the die runs in the way it has been designed and performing. Performance of the die and the total die life, that is the issue, which is a direct link to the cost factor. There may be die coming at a very low price. It may not last your full life cycle of the component. You go in for an extra die. What's the point? Why can't we be honest and in giving the right price to the original customer with the intention of the life cycle and the quantity the tool is supposed to perform? All this, if it is taken care of, is in the interest of the customer. So the basic point is a good rapport and partnership between the customer and the tool maker is a necessity.
When we are talking about the quality and the competition, we are competing with the China, the giant in almost all the industry. How we can improve the competition and reduce importing Chinese mold, or how we can compete with them?
Competing with China is a issue on which, now as we compare Chinese supply of tooling and our tooling, when we are talking about competition today, people are looking only from one point of view, that is the cost. The cost at which the Chinese are supplying, when you compare the costing done in our country, you'll be surprised to note the people are buying tools at the cost of raw material we procure in our country. Logically, it is an impossible proposition, is the reality, and it is a short-term issue. Long-term, over the years, we have come to know, I think most of the people who have been sourcing from China have come to realize that Indian tools are equally competitive for the like-to-like product we are talking about. The issue is, when you compare like-to-like competition only, we can say, are we in a position to say we are better off, or is Chinese better off? So cost factor is not a comparison zone at all, number one. Number two, it is maybe a short-term reason, and it is possible because of the scale of operation in China. The scale of operation in China is so massive that the turnover in each tooling factory is in what you call multiples of what a normal biggest tool room in India can do. The employee size, the equipment at their command, the amount of design support, etc. This is the basic infrastructure under which ideal conditions in which they are produced, the costs are coming down. We do not have that scale of operation, the latest machinery we talk about, and the material supply which the government of China manages to give them at a very, very decent price. Our material is invariably imported, hence, and the starting at the raw material itself, we are not comparable. Then comes the value addition of the tool maker and the machining, etc., which per se cannot vary as far as productivity is concerned, as far as other basic value addition costs are concerned. It's only the difference is coming in the input price of the raw material at which it is got, and the last is the cost of the manpower and the profit margins at which is willing to work. If you look at the original so-called Chinese tool being costly, it was a dumping which was going on. It was dumping. It was almost dumping. It wasn't a question of the. I think today most of the customers who are talking Chinese are today willing to buy from the Indian tool maker. But the only drawback today is he would like to buy from an Indian tool maker, but there is no capacity. Every unit customer wants a set of toolings to be done in a particular period of time, which is impossible to source from one single tool room So he has to go to multiple. These are all the issues which are the driving factors for people going out to procure the tooling. When a set of tooling required for a particular delivery of a component or this thing is not be feasible in India, is another driver to seek deliveries in another place. So today, if you take compete in our scale of operations in India is too small, and the tool rooms are not growing. Capable, good tool rooms are not growing at the rate at which it could have. Due to many, another issue is being the manpower also, because to getting the machine doing its service is okay. But as far as India is concerned, we are not on a level playing field to compare China with us. We are not on a level playing field. One, input supplies costs are less. Number two, manpower there is totally different. We are bound by a lot of Indian rules, regulations and cost, which doesn't apply in China in many ways. People work on two shift basis of 12 hours, etc. Number two, equipment and all, maybe at, I don't know, I'm understanding that people don't even invest. There are government agencies putting entire investments for them and they are just to operate it. So the whole, the comparison to Indian tooling with the interest rate at which he borrows a machine and starts running and the inputs of the material he buys and invests, all this taken together is a totally a, not a level comparable plane at all. If you compare two tool makers in India, I think with the same per se level playing, I think it both are competitive. And I think even today, vis-a-vis China, Indian tool makers have proven that they can beat the delivery time, they can also be competitive on pricing as well. But however, I think we all OEMs, etc., must look at if they are looking to meet the gap in the tooling requirements locally, indigenously, must help the Indian tooling industry, tool makers, to somehow bridge the gap of the capital equipment addition, see that the manpower he can afford to add, all those things. Indian, I think a lot of things are changing for the better. I think it should not be long with the present mindset of the OEMs willing to procure indigenously. If it sets in, things will change for good. And I think Indian tool makers can live up to the expectations they have.
What message you want to give to the Indian tooling and molding industry?
I would say that nothing is impossible. Never say die. We too can also make it happen. There's nothing which is unique, which is happening, which Chinese can do, or which Germans can do, or which anybody can do. Knowing the right inputs, the right technology, the right technology and the process, which is more important, and lot of innovative ways are there to cut down, crash the prices. Cost cutting, there are numerous ways to do it. Not necessarily at the cost of quality. At the same quality, everything, there are innovative ways to improve upon productivity levels, design changes, etc., which can deliver the same tool at a competitive price and quality. So it is a question of applying the mind and what you say, we can do it. We will make it happen. We can make it, and it will happen. That's the positive thinking which is necessary.
Thank you so much, Mr. Surendranath. Thank you for sharing your valuable time. Thank you so much for being with Modern Plastics TV.